Now let us start talking about the force exerted by a jet on a series of radial curved vanes. So this is how a series of curved vanes would look like. Now very important difference in this arrangement is that the tangential velocity at inlet and the tangential velocity at outlet are different because the radius is different of this blade at inlet and outlet. So if u1 is the tangential velocity at inlet, then you will have u2 as the tangential velocity at outlet. So you can say that if this entire wheel on which these curved vanes are arranged is moving with an angular velocity of omega, if I multiply that with r1, that is the radius at the inlet, this would be u1, and for u2 I can use omega into r2. So this clearly shows that because r1 and r2 are different, then u1 and u2 will also be different. Okay, so this is one major difference that is there in this particular case compared to the flat plates. So the mass flow rate of water striking the curved vane would be, let us say, m dot rho a into v1. Okay, now with mass I can find out the momentum. So the momentum per second striking the plate at inlet, this would be mass into the flow velocity at inlet. That's the, sorry, not the flow but the whirl velocity. So whirl velocity is vw1, so this becomes rho a into v1 into vw1. Similarly, you can have momentum per second at outlet, so that would be minus omega rho v1 into vw2, because this vw1 is in this direction and this vw2 is in the opposite direction. So that is why you have this negative sign over here. So this is the momentum per second at inlet and this is the momentum per second at outlet. Now let's find out the angular momentum. The angular momentum per second at inlet. I will have to multiply this particular value with the radius. So I'll have rho a v1 vw1 into r1. Okay, similarly the angular momentum at outlet, this would be minus rho a v1 vw2 into r2. Now if I have to find out the torque on this wheel, I would have to take the difference of the angular momentum. So the rate of angular momentum change would give you the torque exerted. So torque T is equal to the rate of angular momentum change. So this is at inlet and this is at outlet. So inlet minus outlet gives you the momentum change. Because it is per second, so this is obviously per unit time. You will have rho a v1 is common, rho a v1 is common into vw1 into r1 plus vw2 into r2. Why plus? Because minus and minus will give you plus. So this is the torque exerted on this wheel. Now due to this torque there will be some work done, and that work done per second, work done per second is equal to torque into omega, that is the angular velocity. So put the value over there. So you will get rho a into v1. If you multiply omega with r1 over here and r2 over here, you get u1 and u2 in these two places. So we will have vw1 into u1 plus vw2 into u2. So this is the work done per second by the jet on these curved vanes. Okay, now this expression is only true if beta is less than 90 degrees. Alright. But if the beta becomes more than 90, that is, it becomes obtuse. If beta is more than 90, then the work done will become rho A V1 into VW1 U1 minus VW2 into U2. So there will be a minus over here. So in general, we can have plus minus. If it becomes radial, that is, the outlet becomes radial, that is, now V2 is coming like this. So this value will become 0. So VW2 is 0. So in that case, if beta is 0, that is radial outlet, so you will have work done as rho A V1 VW1 into U1. That is the work done per second on this arrangement. So this is, or these three are the cases that you should remember to calculate the work done per second by the jet on this series of curved vanes. Okay, so I hope you got this entire explanation. Now after this, let's derive a value or an expression to find out the efficiency of this jet.